I need a haircut in the worst way. I need to get a haircut this afternoon.
We're back on pregame.com. I'm Pauly Howard. That's Teddy Covers. It's going to be a lot of fun how the wise guys attack the divisional round. We'll get to all the upsets the last 9-10 years coming up. But let's go back and talk about the history where this round was just bet these teams off the bye, and they were killing it ATS.
Yeah, for 20 years. It was a strategy that worked, and it was so simple. You just bet the better team off the bye, expecting the teams that showed up the previous week to have some problems when they went on the road and faced the elites. And it worked. It worked consistently. If you look at a long-term sample size, you're going to see that NFL teams coming off a bye are a winning proposition. You look at a 30-year sample size, you'll say, yeah, that's a great bet. We have to look towards the home favorites at this time of year. But, Paul, as you're about to tell us, sometimes long-term sample sizes can be very misleading.
Everything you know, throw out, especially where you think who the top quarterbacks are going to be or a team comes in on a roll. I have to back that team. This is astonishing. In the last nine postseasons, Brady, Manning, Breeze, a combined 23-19 with two rings. In the last nine postseasons, and I'll throw in the win against Pittsburgh Saturday, Sanchez, Eli, Flacco, 22-9 with three rings.
So you're saying that the trio of Flacco, Joe Flacco,
yes,
Mark Sanchez, and Eli Manning has outperformed Tom Brady, Peyton Manning, and Drew Brees,
yes,
over the course, not just for a year or two, for the last 9 years.
And, and
those are straight up. That's,
yeah,
not even against the spread. Against,
right,
the spread, the lesser teams have been far superior than the elite level squads.
Flacco has 10 playoff wins. Manning has 11. So when Harbaugh said, you know, best quarterback in the league, I'll take him. Mm-hmm. Well, I look at his last five playoff starts. He's 5-0 with 13 touchdowns and no interceptions.
Yeah, when you look at his seven road playoff wins, Joe Flacco has more road playoff wins than anybody in NFL history. That's impressive.
It is. It is.
But so, it's not just that. Talk about some of the teams that have gone down. I mean, yeah, we're talking about straight-up losses at home off a bye in the playoffs.
Right. So going back the last 10 years, last time we had chalk, and when I talk about chalk, that's all four teams off the bye winning. That was 2004. You had 2005, Indy, 14-2. They got beat. 2006, San Diego, 14-2. They lost. Baltimore was 13-3. They got beat. Dallas was 13-3. Tennessee was 13-3. In 2008, three teams off the bye got beat. 2009, the 13-3 Chargers and New England. 2010 Patriots, 14-2. They'd won eight in a row. Four of the wins by 29 points or more. They beat the Jets that year at home 45-3. They played the Jets in the playoffs.
Mark
lost.
Sanchez.
That's right. 28-21. 2012, Broncos had won 11 in a row. They beat Baltimore on the road 34-17. The game wasn't that close. They met in the playoffs, Raheem Moore game.
Mm-hmm.
They lose.
Yeah.
So it's just Green Bay 15-1, New England 14-2, San Diego 14-2. These are great teams on a roll coming in. First playoff game, one and done.
Yeah, the bye doesn't necessarily help them. And you didn't even mention the one that always stands out to me is the Saints. When they,
yes,
won the Super Bowl, the year where they were undefeated at home, they were perfect against the spread at home, they were laying three to Minnesota, got bet up to 3.5, and they needed every one of Brett Favre's, what, five turnovers in that ballgame to escape with the three-point win in overtime, a push for some, a loss for most. So they won the game. They're not even in your straight-up losses, but the strongest home fields don't necessarily carry over into January. And we'll talk about that in a few minutes when we do our game previews for this coming weekend. Talk about how the home field in Foxborough isn't worth quite as much as you think, mm-hmm, et cetera, et cetera. Even the home field in Seattle last year in the postseason isn't what it once was. But the classic example that I always use when you talk about long-term sample sizes versus shorter sample sizes is the Monday Night Football home underdog.
Uh-huh.
If you look at a 35-year history of Monday Night Football home underdogs, you're going to say, wow, what a great bet. I've got to bet every single Monday Night Football home underdog because over the last 35 years, they cashed it better than 60%. You know, you blindly bet it. Then you start to break it down. Well, in the 70s, it was a huge bet. They cashed like 80% of the time. And in the 80s, it was almost as good, like 78% for a decade. In the 90s, it still showed a profit. If you have bet every Monday Night Football home dog here in the 21st century, you've lost a fortune betting on this long-term sample size. They're going to say it's a great bet. Huh? Not over the last 15 years. Over the last 15 years, it's hitting less than 40%. Consistent losing proposition. And it's a similar story here with these teams coming off the bye. The long-term sample size says great. The short-term sample size, not so much lately.
Are you looking to fade Peyton Manning when we get to the playoffs based on what he's been able to, not to do, how he struggled in the playoffs?
Not, if I'm fading Denver, it's not going to be a bet against Peyton Manning. Okay. It's going to be a bet against other aspects of the matchup.
Okay.
It's not a straight, oh, I got to fade Peyton, you know. And, of course, the weather forecast.
Yeah, well, we haven't had a bad weather game. Guy has lucked out 3 years in a row where he's getting 45 degrees for the playoffs.
Welcome to global warming.
Right. That was a lot of fun. Nice work.
Hey, I appreciate that, Paul.
Good luck out there. Four games this divisional round, and we'll see you next time on pregame.com.